Hey everybody, welcome back. I am just getting the music going here and then I'll be ready to join you. It's our bodyweight workout today, so no equipment is required. Whew. All right, let me just get this music going here. A few extra lights. Okay. Bit of a upbeat workout today, so we're gonna get a little more upbeat music here. All right. I still haven't figured out how to edit videos after they've been recorded live, so be kind of a less than entertaining start to the video anyways. All right, welcome back. I'm Stuart with MORFIT. We have our bodyweight workout today at noon. We're a couple minutes late here. Apologize about that. So just find some space on the floor. We're gonna get warmed up. All right. Okay, so let's get our warm up going here first. Just start with some high knees. We're running on the spot, jogging on the spot. Our theme today is going to be high intensity bursts followed by isometric or static holds. We got 6 rounds today, so we're looking at about, once we get going, probably just under 30 minutes of actual work. Excuse me. All right, jumping jacks. So we get nice and warmed up here because we're going to be going right into the workout. Sometimes we have cardio infused into the workout, but not today. So we'll make sure we get all that taken care of in our warm-up. All right, come on into some bodyweight squats. Down and up, take them easy. Knees out, heels down. Try to get a little bit lower down as you get through more reps. We got 3 more, and I'm going to stay at the bottom of the squat on this one. Let's get down. Elbows inside the knees if you can reach. I'm going to twist and reach up to the ceiling with one hand. Bring that arm back in, off to the other side. And back to the first side. Bring it down, second side. One more. And switch. Very good. Hands are going to go down to the floor. Bring your knees down to the floor. Hips up nice and tall. We're going to lean back and come back upright. So these are quad raises. Just a nice little warm up on the quads. One more. Good, hands to the floor. Get your feet back down. We're gonna go into a downward dog. Stretching out through the back of the legs. I'm gonna take your left heel, kick your left leg up, reach it up to the ceiling, and then step it forward into a lunge outside the left hand. From here, we're gonna extend both knees. And then come back down to the downward dog position. We're gonna do that one more time. I'll show from the side here. So we're in a deep lunge, extend both knees, to stretch out the back of the legs, and back into the lunge. All right, step out with the left leg, back to downward dog. We're now gonna kick up the right heel. Really reaching up to the ceiling. And pull that foot through. Lunging on the other side. You get a nice stretch to the hip flexor in this lunge. Now extend both knees. Stretching out the back of the leg. Back to the lunge. And up again. Back to the lunge. We're gonna turn 90 degrees to our left. Keeping the feet nice and wide. And just kind of straighten out and bend the knees one at a time to just work a little bit deeper into that inner thigh stretch. All right, come back to a squat position. From here, we're gonna place our hands behind us. So we're in this crab position. We're gonna drive our hips up, head goes back, crab extension. We have a similar movement in the workout today. So if you can already identify that your shoulders do not like this position, when we come to it in the workout, instead of being on the hands, you can do it from your shoulders, lying on the floor instead. So keep that in mind as we get to the workout. I will remind you, surely. Okay, back to our squat position here. Last thing we're gonna go to is seated. Drop your knees off to the left-hand side. 90 degrees at both legs. Just drop your chest down to your shin. Get a bit of a glute stretch. Tuck your left elbow into the hip. Roll to your back. Tuck your right elbow into your hip. And glide your chest along the shin. So we're stretching onto the right side now. Let's roll back to the first side. Tuck the right elbow into the right hip. Roll to the back. Keep your elbows tucked and glide along the shin. All right, let's roll again. Final roll. Good. All right. Come on up. Anything else that you know you need to warm up or stretch before you work out? Now's the time to get it done. I will explain our workout. All right. So we have six circuits to go through, or six sections of the workout. Each section will have only two exercises. The first exercise is going to be more dynamic, explosive, lots of movement. And the second exercise is going to be isometric, or we're just holding a position. The first exercise, we're gonna work for 20 seconds, rest for 10. Work for 20, rest for 10. Work for 20, rest for 10. So three sets of 20 seconds, and then we're gonna go to the second exercise and hold it for 40 seconds. Then we're gonna go back to the first one and we're gonna repeat it all again. Three sets of 20 seconds of work, and then 40 seconds of rest on, or sorry, 40 seconds at work on the second exercise. Any exercise that might be unilateral, we'll just do one side the first round, and then we'll do the other side the next round. If it's a bilateral exercise, then we do the whole thing twice. All right, let me show you our first two exercises. They're both gonna be quad-based. So the first one is a drop squat. Start by standing up. We're gonna jump our legs out to a squat position. If you can touch the floor, great. If you can't get that low without losing spine position, then just go as low as you can. And then we're gonna come back up, reach up, legs together, and then back down. So it's a drop squat. If you have weights with you, like dumbbells, kettlebells, and you wanna just hold it in this goblet position, then feel free to add some weight to the exercise. Your isometric will be a wall sit. So find a wall, or a fridge, or a friend, and you're gonna hold that position for 40 seconds. All right, so those are the first two. Are we ready? We got our timer here, so tell us when to start and stop. Starting with the drop squats. And if jumping is no good, you can just do squats instead. All right, here we go. So out, touch if you can, up and back down. And it's just a continuous motion, trying not to pause at the top or at the bottom. See how many reps you can get in your 20 seconds. Good, and rest. We're gonna do that two more times before we go to the wall sit. Let's get ready. And here we go. Try to get a little bit higher on your jumps here. Higher or more reps. Go for height or speed. Almost there. Three, two, one. Good. Already feeling the quads warming up nicely. One more set of 20 seconds. We'll get the 10 second break and then we're on the wall. Here we go. Chest up tall on your squats. Four, three, two, one. All right, wall sit time. We're here for 40 seconds. Three, two, one. Here we go. Do your wall sit. Ideally, your hips are at the same height as your knees. So hopefully you're not just leaning up against the wall. Take a look down at the floor. You want to see your knees over top of your heels. If you're getting pressure in front of your kneecaps, it's probably because your feet are too far back. But we don't want the heels way out in front of the knees either. That makes it easy. So try to get your 90 degree position. Hands not on the legs. Get them off. All right. Let's get ready. We're going right back to the drop squats. So repeat that whole thing one more time. Three, two, one. Here we go. Halfway. Hips go back. Chest stays up. Try to avoid this sort of thing. We don't want to be round in the back. All right. Let's get ready. Two, one. Here we go. Second last round of drop squats. And we don't come back to these later. Three, two, one. All right, one more. One more and then back to the wall set. Already sweating, that's a good sign. Here we go. We have no burpees in today's workouts. That's my Easter gift to you. All right, wall sit. Here we go. Try to keep the hands off if you can. If they naturally want to go there, that's fine. But try not to push through the hands. Keep breathing. Got about four big breaths left. Three, two, and time. Nice work. All right, 1 minute rest in between rounds. Enough time for me to show you what's coming up. So, we're gonna go into an alligator side plank. Preferably from the elbow, preferably from the feet, but go to your knee if you need to. The top leg and the top arm stay straight, they come together, meeting in the front, and then they come back over top. That's our 20 second exercise. The 40 seconds is going to be a side plank on the same side. just holding the side plank. And then on the second set, we'll switch over to the other side of the body. All right, 10 seconds. Let's get ready here. Push your body away from the floor with that planted elbow. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Try to keep the swinging arm and leg fairly straight. If that's too tough, you can do a knee to elbow motion instead. That's fine too. Rest. All right, we got two more of those. 2, 1, here we go. See if you can keep the arm and leg parallel to the floor. So try not to let them drop down. Keep the hips up. Nice work. All right, one more set of 20. And then we get a 10 second break before we hold for 40. Here we go.
Our next round, we got strider jumps.
and then an isometric lunge. So, strider jumps, we've done these before a number of times. We're jumping laterally and then back. You can either stay high or you can get low into it, your choice. The second exercise is an isometric lunge. So find your lunge position, dropping down just before the knee touches the floor, hands off the legs, and we're hanging out there for 40 seconds. All right, 20 seconds, we get started. All right, 10 more, strider jumps coming up. Either go for speed, or depth, or height, if you're jumping high, or a combination of. Here we go. 20 seconds. If you don't have the space, you can always do split jumps, distance squat like that. Or if you're not comfortable going side to side, that's a lot of ankle stability, that's fine too. Here we go. Ten more. Good. One more set of those coming up. And then you'll pick a leg for your lunge. Here we go. Almost there. All right, pick a leg. I'm going to my left side first. 3, 2, 1. Try not to put your knee on the floor. Try not to have your back leg straight out like this. That also makes the movement a lot easier. Woo! I'm taking a couple breaks. You go the whole 40 if you can. I got tired legs. Good. Make sure you remember which leg was in front. You gotta switch that up on the next round. All right. Back to strider jumps. Here we go. I'm trying to jump high. And it's just not going. It's okay. I'll keep the load state. Woo. All right. 5 days in a row of 2 workouts per day will do that to you. Looking forward to the weekend. Here we go. Moment of break is after this. Woo! You keep going.
Less than 10. Woo. That was a tough for me today. Okay.
I mean it. That's it. All right. That's another round in. Nice work. Get some water. All right, let's go now. We got two rounds to go. So, we're gonna go to a squat to plank. So from a squat position, hands on the floor, kick out to a plank, back to the squat, but you stay down here, and then you go back out again. Your isometric is going to be a full plank. So lots of plank work for the next 5 minutes. All right, hopefully you got some water. Shook the legs out, shook the arms out a bit. Squat to plank is first. Try to get the heels down. 3, 2, 1. Plank, squat. Plank, squat. Full plank, full depth squat, as you can tolerate. All right, one down. Two more before we plank. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Two down. One more. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Oh, you gotta love this stuff, don't you? Whew. I'm spending a bit more time in my squat because I know the planks are coming up. Whoa. All right, 40 second plank. You choose your variation. Here we go. I think this is the first traditional plank we've done in the live workouts, I think. Oh no, second time. We did that 30 second, 1 minute, 90 second, 2 minute, 2.5 minute, 3 minute plank. Somewhere around episode 8 or 9 or 10 or something. This is only 40 seconds. We can do that. All right, come on up. So, we're gonna repeat all of that again. Squat to plank, here we go. Let's start. Your shoulders are done, spend more time in your squat. Two, one, come on. I have some good news for you. Here we go. The good news, using our sixth circuit, the last one, there's no shoulder work. Well, is there no body support work? Shoulders are working, but not this much. Woo! Okay, we got one more squat to plank, and then our final plank hold. Here we go, 20 seconds. Now the shoulders and the legs are tired. All right, full plank, 40 seconds. Can we do it? I think we can. Here we go. your elbows. Knees go to your knees. Drop to your knees. Just make sure there's no pain in the low back. We're working the front here, not the back side of the body. So feel those abs working. That's it. Nice work, guys. Way to stick it out. Okay. Last round. Last round is star jumps. So everything goes up and out. And then back in. If you're not good with that kind of jumping or that's too fast, you got jumping jacks. The second one is the Superman. Face down on the floor. Arms and legs up. Arms to the side if you need to make it easier. Or down by your waist if you need to make it easier than that. So last round. We start in 10. Woo, another sweaty one. All right. Let's get ready. Star jumps. Four jumping jacks. Here we go. Three, two, one. seconds of work. Here we go. BODYWEIGHT, might be BODYWEIGHT flow. It's the one before the kettlebell flow. That one was a lot of just sort of dynamic flow yoga-esque movement patterns. So if you want a bit of a more of a stretch workout, then maybe go check that one out. All right, what are we doing a lot of today? We got a lot of quads in, so let's stretch our quads out. Grab hold of a wall if you need for balance. Grab the left ankle. Keep the legs together, pull the knee back, squeeze the glutes, push the pelvis forward as you pull the knee back. So from the side, we're here. Try not to have it flare out. And you can do this one lying down on the floor on your side if you prefer as well. Okay, release that. Grab the right ankle. Let the breath come back down, heart rate recenter back closer to a resting level. Always feels nice when the workout's done, doesn't it? Good sense of accomplishment. Okay, release the quad. We did a fair amount of pec work as well, so let's find our wall. Bent elbow on the wall or straight elbow. I'm gonna go straight elbow today, get a bit more bicep stretch in there. I'm gonna place my body against the wall and then turn away from the wall. We didn't really do much biceps today. It's body weight. It's a trickier muscle to work with body weight. But we are gonna work the biceps a fair amount in our heavyweights workout at 5 p.m. today. I'm just gonna make sure I get my biceps stretched out, ready for the workout tonight. Other side, please. Straight arm or bent arm. Turn away from the wall with the torso. You'll feel that stretch in front of the shoulder. Another five, four, 3, 2, and 1. All right, guys, that puts us right around 45 minutes, so I'm gonna do my sign off here. As always, thanks very much for participating, enjoying the workouts. Hopefully you're keeping up with good intensity and energy and not following my general demise throughout the week. I'm probably going to be moving away from two workouts a week, maybe next week or the following. We're actually going to be looking to launch some specialized classes that you'll be able to register for, and it'll be accessible only to people who register. But I will keep going with the free workouts at least once a day, because they're good for me, and I think they're good for you. So if you want more information on the specialty classes that you can register for, check out the website, see what's coming up, and maybe let us know if there's anything you're interested in. Maybe you just want a kettlebell series, or you want to see the maces, or yoga, or something like that. And I can start talking to some of our instructors and see who's interested in coming in to maybe teach a class on an ongoing basis. So let us know your thoughts. Thanks again for participating. Maybe I'll see you for the heavyweights workout at 5 o'clock today. If not, have a wonderful weekend. It's going to be beautiful out there, I think. Take care, guys.